Well, this equation certainly makes things a little bit easier. Because we did the same thing to both sides, and we didn't do anything crazy like try to divide by zero, whatever answers we come up with from here on out will still work for our original equation, either of these two right here. The difference is that now when we solve, we only have to deal with two factors that are multiplied together, instead of three, like we had when we had that constant term out here as well. Let's think about what we can deduce at this point. We have two factors that, when multiplied together, give us zero. Let's call one of them a, and the other one b. Then we can write this equation as ab equals zero. Thinking about this equation, can we conclude anything about what either a or b should equal? Please answer yes or no.